As of January 12th of 2025, there are currently 44 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 3 more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Taal volcano in the Philippines, which once again joined the aforementioned list via a phreatomagmatic explosion from its central and highly acidic crater lake. The bright spots in this video footage represent ejected bombs of lava, marking Taal's first eruption since December 3, 2024. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In El Salvador, the massive lake-filled caldera of the Ilopango volcano was reported to produce an elevated level of degassing, which formed large bubbles in said lake after a regional strong magnitude 6.2 earthquake. Meanwhile, across Indonesia, 3 new volcanic eruptions occurred this week, bringing the number of erupting volcanoes in the country from 6 to 9. Yes, 9. And in what is this week's top story, the massive underlying magma dike in central Ethiopia has expanded to 52.6 kilometers or 32.7 miles in length. This magma dike expanded to this length from 35 kilometers long since December 29th, primarily expanding to the northeast but also slightly expanding to the southwest. Despite seismic activity continuing to decrease during the last week, it has still remained high, and now, since this latest intrusion of magma began, a grand total of 10 magnitude 5 range earthquakes and 91 magnitude 4 earthquakes have struck since December 23rd, causing widespread damage. However, as long as these earthquakes in an area with many structures not built to withstand them continue, and the risk of an imminent volcanic eruption remains, the 80,000 people currently evacuated are likely to remain away from their homes. There are several new pieces of information, one of which is concerning. For one, the aforementioned magma dike has likely extended to the northern outskirts of the vicinity's largest city, Medihara, which has a population of 21,000. For obvious reasons, it would be disastrous if the magma dike, which is presumably at shallower than 3 kilometers depth, did end up erupting there, but the good news is that this possibility seems unlikely at the present. As, while we have seen unprecedented levels of uplift due to this massive magma intrusion, which I interpret to involve at least 480 million cubic meters of magma, not all of the ground deformation being witnessed is purely uplift. While the northern rift area has risen by a whopping 1.7 meters or 66.9 inches since December 22nd, with 1.3 meters of this figure occurring since December 29th, the southern portion of the aforementioned dike has actually subsided by up to 55 centimeters. The reason for this, at least in my interpretation, is that the expanding magma dike encountered an underlying body of cooling magma associated with the Fentale volcano's 1810 eruption. This body of magma then began draining into the underlying dike, causing the overlying ground to subside by nearly a half meter. Magma still seems to be flowing towards and expanding to the northeast in the dike, reaching the western end of the rhyolitic Dofen shield volcano. However, since this dike contains magma associated with the Fentale volcano, if an eruption were to occur, it would truly be considered an eruption from Fentale. The known recent location and expansion of the magma dike creates increasing evidence that the January 3rd explosions witnessed may have been a phreatic volcanic eruption instead of a hydrothermal explosion. Regardless, volcanic unrest is still ongoing here. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, this week saw 3 new eruptions begin in the country, specifically at Luatolok early on January 5th, Dieng on January 6th, and Karenating also on January 6th. Luatolok's eruption on Lembata Island has so far only consisted of weak and intermittent ash emissions rising less than 500 meters above its summit. Whether this progresses to an eventual magmatic eruption remains to be seen. As for the Dieng volcano on the island of Java, its Salari crater produced a brief 57-second-long phreatic eruption at 10:58 a.m. on January 6th. This only created a 100-meter-high eruption plume, throwing fragments of mud up to 50 meters beyond the edge of its crater rim. As for Karenating, slow basaltic andesite lava fusion resumed from its southern lava dome on January 6th, which is still ongoing at the present. And in El Salvador, a strong magnitude 6.2 earthquake struck offshore of the country on January 5th at 11:18 a.m. local time. However, this quake caused strong enough shaking, translating to a peak MMI of 5.5, causing damage to a dozen homes. Well, widely posted social media footage also showed what appeared to be an abnormal level of rising gas forming bubbles on the surface of the Ilopango Volcano's caldera lake. So, did the earthquake cause a change in this explosive volcano which has not erupted since 1880? No, as MMI shaking of 5 or higher is needed to possibly trigger a change, yet the lake experienced maximum shaking of a 4. As confirmed by several locals, the rate of underwater fumaroles degassing was not abnormal after the earthquake, as this level of activity is actually quite typical here. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on January 11th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, GooneyDJ, for supporting my work.